yeast troublesome fire started on October 14, 2020, northeast of Kremlin, Colorado. Low overnight humidity and high wind gusts primed the area for fast wildfire conditions. Within 9 days, it had burned nearly 200,000 acres and reached the east side of the Continental Divide. The East Troublesome Fire is an especially notable case study for Colorado because it spread nearly 87,000 acres in just one 24-hour period. Wildfire forecast models give us estimates of fire spread that can help inform active fire response and evacuations. But these models rely on accurate information, and until now, we've lacked up-to-date vegetation data. In fire science language, we call this fuel data. The ways we've traditionally collected fuel data can be labor-intensive, and compiling and verifying them can take a long time. Although the fuel data are published as frequently as these methods have allowed, they are easily outpaced by events like flooding and drought that dramatically change the characteristics of fuels in an area, and subsequently, the accuracy of the fuel data itself. At the time of the East Troublesome Fire, the only available fuel data showed the trees as healthy and standing. If we were to model fire in a healthy forest, like the available fuel data represented, the trees would hold more moisture, and their upright position makes them more challenging to ignite. However, a lot of the forest was actually dead and downed due to drought, beetle infestation, and wind events that occurred since the last fuel data had been published. Dead, downed trees tend to hold less moisture, and their positioning on the ground makes them more accessible to ignition. If we model the East Troublesome Fire using updated fuel data that captures the dead, downed trees, the fire moves more quickly, and we have a better representation of what actually happened. To help fill the gap in data, we can now update the fuel data using satellite imagery. The satellite imagery is able to tell us where the vegetation is green and healthy, and where it's brown and dry. It can also tell us where the most beetle-infested areas are, where the trees are lying on the ground, and where they're still standing, and funnels it into categories of severity that are simple for the model to digest. Wildfires are a natural ecological process that will continue to occur. But with more accurate information, our ability to save lives and property can be dramatically improved. If we can predict with greater certainty, we can act with better tools and strategies in hand.